Well, howdy ho there again, boys and girls, and welcome to yet another edition of Live from the Tape Farm. Today we are going to be starting a project that is full of firsts, things that I have never done before. We're going to be doing some modifications to the Firefly FFPJ, the Firefly Bass with jazz bass, precision bass pickup types in it. If you hadn't seen my original review on this, go ahead and check it out. I'll put a little link up in the corner here. There'll also be a link in the description. It's a really cool bass for $169 for sure. One of the areas that I noted that I felt it was lacking in was a little bit in the pickups, only because they were a little bit microphonic. Waxing them would resolve that issue. But I thought, you know, I'd really like to do a pretty heavy modification. Something I've never done before. I'd like to kind of expand my horizons, if you will. Sure, I could put new pickups in there. All right, we're going to do that. We're going to put some pickups in there. But what we're going to put in there are some active pickups. I've never actually had a guitar of any kind with active pickups. From Guitar Fetish, I have some of their Red Active bass pickups and all the circuitry that goes with that. So that's one first, active pickups. The next first is, you know, I've never had a fretless bass before. I've kind of toyed with them, but I wouldn't say I'm proficient on a fretless bass. So we're going to turn this guy into a fretless bass. So I got myself a fret removal tool, and we're going to pull the frets on here. We're going to fill in those slots the same way Jaco did back in the day. Famously, Jaco Pastorius, one of the most world-famous bass players of all time, pulled the frets out of his jazz bass, filled it with wood filler, and then covered the fretboard in epoxy to protect it. Because one thing the frets do, aside from giving you a place to put your fingers and so you know what note you're hitting, the frets also kind of protect the fretboard from round wound strings. So if you want to use flat wounds, you could, and I have a bass I use on flat wounds, the Beetle bass here. And I could put flat wounds on this, and I might, but I'm also wanting to protect the fretboard if I do happen to use round wounds. So we will have to put a coating over the wood. In this case, I've been doing some research on using super glue, CA glue. Basically what we'll do is we're going to sand it and radius it and make it all nice and pretty, then cover it in CA glue, multiple coats of CA, and then sand it and polish it. So basically when we're done, we'll have a nice hard clear finish on the fretboard. I'm also going to fill in the slots with some wood filler the same way Jaco did. When you play a fretless, you're going basically on that line to get the note. So I'll still have some sort of guide as to where I need to put my fingers for playing purposes. It's going to be a lot of learning experiences for me, especially when it comes to pulling the frets and doing that finish on the fretboard. So we got a lot of work to do, so let's get to it. We'll be right back. Am I right? I have run into a bit of a snag. I have wired, rewired, and troubleshooted these pickups quite extensively. Whenever I bring the volume up on the P-style pickups, the volume drops and the sound becomes very thin. The jazz bass pickup by itself sounds fine. Like I said, I have checked and rechecked all of these connections dozens of times, and I think I got a bad set of pickups, is what I think it comes down to. So I have sent an email out to Guitar Fetish to see if we can't get those swapped out. But in the meantime, I'm just going to run it with the jazz bass pickup for now. That should wrap us up for the modifications, some successful, some failed, to the Firefly bass. When somebody asked me about this, I said that the stuff that I thought was going to be easy turned out to be hard, and the stuff that I thought was hard turned out to be easy. Pulling the frets, not difficult. Filling the slots, not difficult. The CA glue finish, while methodical, is very easy to do and something I would definitely consider doing in the future. The results, I think, kind of speak for themselves. I mean, it looks really good. I wouldn't mind trying to see if I could finish a guitar in that way just to see what would happen long term. But the pickups and the electronics, that turned out to be a bit of a bear. Now, I have heard people say that they don't like active pickups, that, you know, they sound dead and lifeless and a few other things. But I thought I'd give them a shot. And one didn't work. The P-bass pickup didn't work. The jazz bass pickup worked, but it did. It just sounded dead. Had no character to it whatsoever. I am going to end up returning those pickups to Guitar Fetish. They are hopefully going to give me a store credit. And eventually maybe I'll get some other pickups for this bass. You know, nothing ventured, nothing gained. That is one thing that I've tried to do on this channel all the time, is if things work, I show you they work. If they didn't work, I show you that too. The only thing is that now I have a battery compartment on this bass. That's completely not needed. But who knows, maybe in the future, somewhere down the line, I'll find some active pickups that I might like. If that's the case, then I have a battery compartment ready to go. It was definitely a good learning opportunity, and very glad I went through the process on the neck. Learned a lot from it. Things I would do differently is I did a lot of sanding before the finish in an attempt to get rid of some of that tear out. I wouldn't do that going forward. I would either live with the tear out or find a way to fix it. And there are ways to fix it, and I have, from all the sanding, I have a nice collection of rosewood dust now, so I could have fixed some of those chip outs. But that's all I got for you today. Questions, comments, concerns? Yep.
Cries of outrage.
Hit me up in the comments below, and we'll catch you guys later.